So it's musical experiments time, and this time it's all about the arranger track in Cubase. The arranger track is a very nice flexible thing that kind of allows an Ableton-like workflow with Cubase, so that you can easily rearrange parts without having to manually copy and paste things. And my usual process is to arrange things with Korg Gadget on the iPad and then mix it with Cubase on the iPad, but I always import the Cubase project on my Windows computer in Cubase so that I have the mixed version there and I can tweak and optimize that a bit further. So I'm working on a project recently which is like a soundtrack project, so let's take a look at how one of the pieces of music is created and how we can experiment with the arrangement. So this is the track. This is the wave output from Korg Gadget, which I have already mixed with Cubase on the iPad and then imported into Cubase. As you can see, it has 14 tracks that you can see over here with volume automation and also various insert effects. For instance, if I look at the channel settings over here, see there's quite a bit going on. That's all stuff that Cubase on the iPad supports, where it was mixed with, and when I import it in Cubase, you get all this stuff. So we can browse through all the different channels. For instance, here's the kick drum, there's some tape saturation. Here are also the EQs, which are based on the presets. And of course, I have some insert effects as well, like this. This is an insert effect from Cubase. I use this to reduce the bass rumble, because that's something you cannot really hear properly on the iPad. And my speakers are kind of bad on my computer. So those are the channel settings. Now let's listen to the track for a bit. Also, here's a section that is slightly bad in the original arrangement. I've labeled this false strings because something sounded a bit false. And in one of the tracks I have kind of muted it out. Yeah, probably this one, to prevent clashing with some of the other instruments. Intro section, where some of the strings are muted. Mm-hmm. So that was the track, that is the arrangement with the WAV files that is completely mixed, but I have also got the MIDI files which I exported from Gadget, and we can play around with that because I have the Gadget VST plugins for the PC, and I can sort of rearrange that. Apparently Cubase has a feature called Arranger Track which allows to do some creative things. Let's take a look at it. Right, I'm now loading up the MIDI version of it, and yeah, this is all imported manually. Every MIDI track from Gadget was imported and I assigned that to an instrument. So here I have all the instruments. Every MIDI channel is assigned to a different Korg Gadget VST, for instance the Korg Wave Station here. Or this one, for instance, Montpellier. It opens up on my other monitor, unfortunately. Very thick analog synth. I have another one of those, playing a different patch. This patch is called Ethereal. Well, we have some drum kits, for instance, Bilbao. Well, and a few others. This is Pompeii. And I have another wave station. Alright, so those are a bit of the instruments. Of course, I also have this one. This is the Glasgow. Has some nice PCM sounds, has some really good strings in particular. And a sort of emulator slash Fairlight style joypad. Right, so that's that. Now let's play this thing. As you can see, it sounds pretty similar, except this version is not mixed. This is the plain vanilla version that has absolutely no plugins or effects or EQs or anything applied to it. And I think we even have the mistake in this section. Oh yeah, something's definitely not right. As you can hear, it is not yet mixed. But of course the purpose of this is to kind of rearrange the arrangement. So what I have done is I created an arranger track here. And we can open the editor and we can completely change the order. For instance, I want to start with a different order. Let's say that I want number C to be first. We can do that. So it starts in a different section. Or what about E? Or the final part. Now it actually starts at the intro, and I can also change the number of repeats. So as you can see, this solution is very flexible. You can use this to do like a sort of Ableton-like workflow. But apparently it is also possible to create like a subsection. So you can have a section within a section. Let's say I want this little piece over here. Or I want a piece of, let's say, this bit. It creates those extra parts. So let's see if we can give this a name. One of them is called section I and section H. So let's drag this in. And actually, let's start with that. Now it plays just this little bit. And now section H is this little bit over here, which is essentially a subpart of section A. But another cool feature is that you can also create like duplicates of your arrangement to have different versions in case you want to try out different concepts. So let's see how we can do that. Here we have the original arrangement, but of course we can just create a new chain entirely and start with H for instance, and then section E, section G, A, just a few parts, and then we can play that one. So as you can see, it jumps from section H to section E, and I is not included. But from there it will go to G. But the interesting thing about this unmixed version is that you can hear some of the instruments differently. Because in the mix the drums are much quieter in volume and loudness. And of course this version is not EQ'd. There, it now jumps to this part, and after it has finished that, it will jump to this part, and then this one. Now it goes back to the intro. So to sum it up, I think the arranger track is very flexible. It allows you to kind of create different versions of an arrangement without having to like copy and paste things and drag things around. This is just super quick. You can easily make different versions of a song, and also you can flatten it once you're satisfied with a particular version. Then it commits those changes, but that is a somewhat destructive process. I hope you enjoyed this little glimpse in one of my latest projects. I hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for watching. Bye bye.